Now, the beauty of the high-speed system is you can not only use it for using for cutting in exotic woods, you know, hardwoods, things like that, but you can also use it for knife engraving on a finished blade. The blade here is a finished blade. It's hardened already, probably like 58, 59 Rockwell. It's a very hard piece of metal. And yet the high-speed system will still cut into it, engrave a piece in it with no stress whatsoever. We use a stencil method, same as on the gun stock. Just use a Xerox machine to apply your design to the transfer material, cut it out, fit it to the blade that you'll be working with, and you're ready to go. You can reposition it all that you want. It doesn't have to be a mirror polished blade. It can be a satin finished or a brush finished. It'll stick without a problem. Won't leave any residue. Just press it down, and you can start cutting. You always want to have something that's going to follow the design of the blade. Granted, that can change if you have a customer that wants something else, but it's just the same process as with the gun stock. Follow the design, figure out how you want it, what your plan of attack is with it, figure out how, if you're going to use just a line design, if you're going to do a deep engraving or where you're going to be removing a lot of metal, and just start out. Here I'll be using a smaller bit because I just want to do the fine outline of the work of the piece first, because I'm going to be using a stippling or pointillism method to give it a 3D effect without removing excessive amounts of metal. Now the design here is done with a cross hatching, which is just using lines. The more lines, the darker it is, and the darker or the rounder the effect is. That can be used just as well. It's a popular design with a lot of the high-end engraving, where they'll do it on a piece that has not been hardened, just because of the fact that they'll usually use hand tools, and you can't do that with a hardened metal, period. There's just no way to do that with the hand pieces, because the hand piece itself is softer than the metal that you would be working with. Yet with a high-speed system, it can be hardened. It'd be a finished blade you buy at a store or a customer gives it to you. Just find a design that fits, put it on, and just start working on it. Now, this design we did here, you're looking at probably 10, 20 minutes. If you're doing just tracing the lines here, you're looking at 5-6 minutes time. Now, if you want to do a large amount of these for, say, like sale at a craft show or gun or knife show, things like that, or even for a consignment sale at a craft show, gun show, or, you know, any number of venues, a design like this, once, especially if you start doing a lot of them, you can cut your time down to almost nothing. So you'd be looking 3-4 minutes a piece, and yet the price you'd charge for it, like a design like this, just follow design in a cross-hatching method like this, you can look, you know, $15-$20. And you can work easily into times where you can earn $1 an hour or $1 a minute, up to $2 or $3 a minute, especially if you get really good at a certain design. Now, when you do custom things, it can get a little more pricey because you're doing something you're not always necessarily familiar with, or they want a more intricate design, or a more like a harder engraving type. Now, here you can see, same as on the gun stock, you pull the transfer off, and the initial edge that I did has got a nice fine line to it. Sometimes you might want to go back and smooth something up if you moved over. That, again, depends on the design you'll be doing. Now here, we're just kind of, this is the finished product. When the bit goes through the transfer, you'll hear it as it cuts into the metal. You want to be sure that you're actually cutting into the metal and not just brazing along the top of the transfer. Because I myself have done a couple of pieces where I'll go through the design, pull a transfer up, and I haven't touched the metal at all. So you don't want to be sure that you're hearing it engraving the metal, but it's not going to be a problem at all with the high-speed system, because it cuts through and it's not going to grab and walk all over the blade on you, so you don't have to like have a death grip on the piece. Now here I'm using what's called a pointillism or stippling method, sometimes referred to hammer tone, and all it is going in and using small round pieces or small round dots that I'm using the engraver for to catch light and bring up lighter areas. Now, the more dots you have, the lighter it is, and the rounder effect you're going to have. Now, that's another version of the cross-hatching, like in pen and ink, and just that I kind of like this version a little better. Now, with the cross-hatching, as you can see in the design here, has the same effect that you're going to have with pointillism, just using straight lines. It's always nice to have the design that you're doing next to you, just to kind of a reference point where your highs and lows are going to be. And then it's just simply going in and recreating the design you want. I'll use sometimes the medium bit, or the number 8 or number 9, to remove larger areas of the design, just to create a little bit, you know, a deep effect or a rounder effect. Then I'll go back in with the fine carbide to create the small dots and have a more subtle gradations for the light to the darker areas in the piece. This is something that is really easy to do. Takes really no skill, because it's something that's so simple to do, and yet it makes a piece look so nice and so personalized that it's amazing how well these things really sell. Craft shows are a big draw, because they sit in the tables, and no matter what light source is out there, whether you're out in a parking lot some places or in a school or something, especially with a pointillism or something like this where there's a lot of engraving in the metal, it's going to catch light and it's going to catch people's eye and draw them to it. Now, some places even allow you to do demonstrations or do it there while you're at the show, which is even better, because then you can just, you know, have customers bring up a little pocket knife or something and say, hey, I'll put a design there for $5. 3 minutes work, you're done. It's so nice. And they really appreciate it, and they've got something that they can say is theirs. It's not just like every other store-bought knife that they've had, that other people have. Now, here's the finished design. You can see how the lights just really grab and give you a depth, and yet the dot or pointillism system allows you to get a rounded feel to it, so it kind of makes it feel like it's kind of standing out from the blade a little bit. Now, this is just one method. There are several techniques. Another one we have here is called filework or jimping. All it is using your handpiece to cut a design into the back of the spine of the knife, and it can either be left empty or it can be filled in with a darkened epoxy as it is here. Now you can do simple block design. You can go all the way up to the edge of the back of the blade, and all it is just mark it with a nice marker or something permanent so you can get the design in the back of the knife where you're going to remove metal. You can do this with a fixed blades like this one. You can do this with pocket knives. Although with pocket knives, it's a little harder with folding or lock blades just because of the fact that the working mechanism is already semi-sealed up. Now you can do this on the blade of the folding knives, and it really looks nice. Not only does it have a nice custom look to it, but it's something that it's done so easily and so quickly, it's almost a shame to charge for it. Now here we're just going to cut in, create a nice fine finished edge with the number 12, I believe. And you just go right across your mark lines. And if you have a problem, you can always just cut a little bit more out, because it's a design that you're doing that really nobody's going to be any the wiser on it. Now, the hardened metals with this, if you're doing the normal technique of file work, you have to clamp it down somehow, you know, in a vise or whatever you have, and then sit there with a hand file and just go back and forth and back and forth. Now, on a non-heat-treated piece of metal, that isn't all that hard, but there are certain things that we can do with the engraver that you cannot do with a file. I mean, it's just physically impossible. You can cut out small round pieces. You can put a person's name in the back there. And that's something you just cannot do with a file, no matter how much you want to try. Now here, as you can see, after you cut the fine line, you just use the large round carbide and just hog out the metal, because you want to make sure the design is deep enough for the epoxy to fit in there and have something to grip onto. Or you can use a diamond piece and clean it out and just get a nice polished look. Now, whether you're making the knife yourself or you're working for a knife maker, this is something that cuts a lot of his time out. I mean, if he had to do this with a file, it's just incredible amounts of time that would be dedicated to doing this. Whereas with a high-speed hand piece like this, you can rip through these things so fast and so cleanly, and you can do designs that just cannot be done with a file. The other possibilities, if you go to a craft show or a gun show or any one of a number of possibilities, or even work in a smaller retail store, you can have customers bring up their pocket knives. You can use the set designs, just apply to what here is called the bolster, or the metal piece on the knife. And all it is just apply the transfer, like with the gun stock and everything else, insert the proper SEM tip, and just trace the line. Now, a design like this, especially if you're going to use it for a production piece, you're going to look at 3 minutes worth of work. And you can make $5, $10, depending on what your market bears is really the important thing. In doing this, you can make anywhere from $1, $3, $4 a minute. It sounds like a lot of money, but I mean, it really works out that quick, because there's just basically really very little time involved. And of course, like with everything else, the more you do it, the quicker you get at it, the less time you have invested in it, the higher your profits are going to be. At a craft fair, things like this really work nice. Now, you can always do knives, things like that. You can also just personalize scissors, letter openers. There's a few companies that have just plain metal letter openers that you can do a whole bunch of things to, and really make some nice custom pieces. And here it is just take the handpiece, and you got a finished little fleur-de-lis design on a pocket knife. And with some of the designs here, we'll be showing you that all it takes is imagination and a will to do it, and you can do some very nice work. Like the high-end engraving you can see on some of the really art knives or some of the expensive pocket knives. But if you've got a couple of $100s, hey, then go for it. But you got to remember, that's always done on unhardened metal. You can't just buy a knife out of the store and say, here, engrave it, because they can't do it on the hardened metals. We can with the high-speed engraving system. And just it's basically limitless to what you want to do. So it's more or less, you know, pick the piece you want, find an area that you like, and have fun and make some money.